Welcome back. Today we are back out chasing some walleyes and I'm going to break down my top five locations for winter walleyes. But before we do that, I have had a heck of a week here. The last five-ish days have been just an adventure, and instead of telling you about it, I'm going to show you a few of the highlights of my last week here. Welcome back. We are back out doing some ice camping. Well, as you may notice, we are not out on the lake. We had a little bit of snowmobile troubles. None of the part stores were carrying my part, so we had to make do. We still have a little bit of daylight. We're going to go see if we can rush out and catch this evening bite.
On it. Acting. That was a giant walleye.
Well, I just got home and I am still a little depressed from losing that giant walleye. But it's a new day tomorrow. I'm heading back to Roseau for New Year's to visit my family, and I'm also going to be taking the snowmobile and the ice house, and we're going to do some exploring on Lake of the Woods. I'm super pumped. Can't wait.
Well, got everything loaded up, came out. Started my pickup and it says reduced engine power, which makes sense because everything is frozen, everything is cold. It is like 51 below zero with the wind chill right now. So when it rains, it pours. Doesn't look like I'm gonna be able to get out and explore on Lake of the Woods this morning either.
Well, as you can see, it's been a very interesting last week, but I am back out, back in the saddle. Gonna try have another evening where just kind of wait it out for a little bit, see if we can't catch a big walleye. There's a chance we might come out here and catch nothing, but that is why I'm going to talk to you about my top five winter locations to catch some walleyes. That way, in case the action is a little bit slow, I can still give you some information that can help you go out tomorrow and put more fish on the ice. So I've got a lot of information coming at you, but first I'm gonna finish getting everything set up so we can hopefully capitalize on this night bite. I feel like I don't even remember what it feels like to hold a fish right now. It's been a long couple days, but all that can change pretty quick. Oop. As I'm saying that, finally bit. Gonna give it a little more time. There, I think he's got it. Oh, not big, but not tiny. Let's see if we can get this one in. Come on. What do we have? And it is a walleye. Oh man. Oh, it feels so good to put a fish on the ice again. Oh, feels like it has been way too long. Decent fish, not the giants we've been looking for. And you can see the other ones that have been down there that have been much bigger. There's still some hope. I'm going to sit out here for a little while longer, see if we can't get a few more of those bigger ones to bite.
All right, while we're waiting for some active fish, I'm going to talk through my top five winter walleye spots. And I'm specifically going to talk more about getting to this mid-winter time, not necessarily early ice. I've talked a little bit about early ice spots in my first couple videos. I'm going to do these in order from five up to my favorite location to target during the winter. Number five is one that I've talked about in a few of my other videos. It's one of my favorite early ice spots. And it's at number five right now because, like I said, it's not as much of a midwinter spot. In my opinion, there's still fish there at times, but definitely a little bit more of an early ice spot. And that is shallower, weedy flats. And I'm also gonna throw in those adjacent break lines. And again, especially with those break lines, you can catch fish throughout the winter on those, even into this midwinter time. The reason I have it at number five is it can be so hit or miss. It can be tough to pinpoint more so the spot on the spot when you have a short amount of time, a short bite window. Sometimes those shoreline breaks, they can be cruising anywhere along there. But anytime you can find some good green weeds, like I said, even if they last into January, sometimes into February, if you can find some good weeds still, there's always going to be fish around those. Number four is one that I've been targeting a lot more in the last couple of years, and it's quickly going up my list as some of my favorite midwinter spots, and that is some of those mid-depth flats. Anywhere from 15 to 25-ish is a very general range. But anytime you have some of those kind of very flat areas, especially when there's some mid-lake structure around, sometimes you see some humps, some points. Those are some really awesome areas to target, especially when it gets to be midday. I really like those spots midday. Not that they can't be good early morning and late evening as well, but it seems like those fish cruise in closer to that structure morning and evening, or during some of those bite windows, whenever that might be. And then they cruise out onto those flats and just kind of cruise around all over the place during the daytime. So if you're looking for a good, maybe a spot to put a permanent house or something that you are looking to have some daytime action, it's definitely not going to be hot action all day because it's such a big area and it's tough to pinpoint exactly where those fish are gonna be because they are just roaming. But it can be a very fun bite when you have a school move through, or you might have a fish here, a fish there, as they're kind of just roaming these flats. Number three is also one of my favorite early ice locations, but also it can be very good midwinter when you find these on a reef. It's more of that spot on the spot when you're seeing them on some of these mid-lake humps, and that is some of these inside turns. I talked about it in one of my previous videos where I was fishing that a little bit shallower, but these can also be into that little bit deeper range, whether mid-range or even out into that 25, 30 foot range. And I love these inside turns, both off of a shoreline, maybe surrounded by a point, or on some of these rocky reefs or some of these mid-lake humps that have some of these smaller little inside turns, because they seem to just funnel fish. Kind of holds fish in on all sides. They can kind of corral them. So it can really be one of those spot on the spot kind of areas where if you're looking to capitalize on, say, a late night bite, you only have an hour to get out, that is a great spot to go because you can target some of the highest percentage areas where these fish are gonna be. And anytime you can find some of these high percentage areas, some of these spot on the spots, these are gonna be some of your best bet, especially as you're discovering a new body of water or maybe a new piece of structure. It's just something that is a little bit different that fish can relate to, and it gives you a higher percentage. That doesn't mean they're always gonna be there opposed to a shoreline break or opposed to just a random break line on that mid-lake structure, but it's just an area that's going to be something unique and something that can hold those fish when other areas they might just be cruising through. On to number two. Number two could also be number one for me, depending on the body of water that I'm on, and that is some saddles. When you have an area where, say, either there's a point sticking out and it kind of drops down and goes on to a hump or another point, anytime you have some of these saddles in between two pieces of structure, it acts almost like a pinch point. From my experience, these saddles aren't necessarily an area that's just gonna hold fish constantly, but what it seems is as these fish are cruising around some of those pieces of structure, those saddles can just be a pinch point where these fish will congregate and they'll move through. So it's a high traffic area, not a high percentage area in the fact of maybe where fish will sit, although they can sit on there as well, especially as it gets closer to that nighttime or early morning. And like I said, depending on the lake, these saddles can be my number one spot that I'll target, but you always have to get to know your lake. Every lake fishes so differently. I fish every single lake in our area differently in what I look for and some of the structure that I look for. And on to number one, my number one location is related to structure, whether it's rocky hump or some big extended point. One of my favorite things to target in the winter is some of these little points that are off of these humps. It just can be a small point, can be a little jut out on these humps, on these deep water points, or it can be a little bit of an extension off the end of some of these points. These are some of my favorite areas because one thing that you notice if you do a lot of driving around with your side imaging, these areas tend to be things like piles of rocks or maybe a little bit of a boulder. It tends to be some sort of structure that fish can relate to. So you can learn a lot by driving around in your boat for these wintertime areas. Anytime you have a little bit of an extension, it's something that as these fish are cruising around the structure, it might be something just to stop them for a little bit. Something to hold them on an area. Maybe there's some sort of bait or it's a little bit of a feeding flat. Especially if this is one of the bigger pieces of structure in the whole lake, that's gonna hold more fish. So the more fish you have on a big structure, that's gonna be more fish moving around either that hump or that rocky point, whatever it might be. So the more fish, the bigger area that you have, it's gonna be a little bit tougher to break down, but once you can pinpoint some of those areas, pretty easy to figure out where some of these sweet spots are on some of this structure. So those are my top five right now. It seems like every year my top five changes depending on what I'm finding as I'm learning more. One of the things that I can always say is never stop learning. every time I meet someone, every time I fish with someone, I learn something new. So never think that you know everything. I by no means know everything. This is what I have had from my experience. So this time next year, I might have a different top five. But right now, if I was going to go to a new lake, these are the first five areas that I would check as I'm starting to break down that lake. So let me know in the comments, do you agree? Do you disagree? Do you have some that you would add? Do you have some that you would completely take out because you haven't had a lot of luck? I'd love to know from you because, like I said, the way to become a better fisherman is to never stop learning. If you learned something, found something from value from that little segment, I would love it if you would like this video because I'm going to continue sharing everything that I've been learning as I put in more and more time out on the ice. Well, I think that's going to do it. Came out swinging for the fences and didn't quite make it happen. A little bit like my actual baseball career. But with all the chaos happening last week and with my wife and I going on vacation here coming up, this is really my only chance to get out and do a little filming. Either way, I hope you found value in this video. A few tips and tricks that can help you catch more fish right now. I like to give some practical tips that you can go out and try tomorrow if you would like. So give some of those locations a shot and see what you find. And again, if you have any suggestions of things I missed or something that you would do instead, I would love to hear them. So drop them in the comments below. I'm gonna start packing up, finish up this week of school, and then I am off for a week on vacation. But after that, I'll be back hitting the ice hard. I have some fun ideas, maybe some trips planned. So stay tuned. We got lots more content coming at you.